described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
New Dementia Media and Questar presents The Time Compass, Persia.
High up in the mountains in the north of Mesopotamia, there lived shepherds called the Persians.
One follows sheep near a village.
For centuries, they were ruled by the powerful empires that dominated Mesopotamia.
File folders are shown.
First, they lived under the Assyrians. And later, they were at the mercy of the powerful Babylonians. But one day, around the year 550 BC, a brave and intelligent Persian man named Cyrus II rode with his cavalry troops into the valley of the Euphrates River and defiantly planted himself in front of the gates of Babylon, which was the most important city of the age.
They stop outside the gates.
From their great city walls, the Babylonians laughed at this small group of warriors who thought they could defeat them.
Several identical warriors wave.
But the Persians, led by their crafty and brave commander, managed to beat the Babylonians and conquer the city.
Later, he looks out onto the city.
Cyrus became a great, powerful, and respected king. Because his people had suffered under the harsh rule of Babylon, he vowed not to be as cruel. And so he allowed everyone to follow their religions openly.
Two men move a statue of a winged animal.
This great act is how the Jews were allowed to return to Jerusalem and reconstruct the Temple of Solomon.
Pictures include Jerusalem on a map and the temple.
And Cyrus's descendants made the Persian Empire even stronger.
More artwork is shown.
This new generation of governors was known as the Achaemenid dynasty. And they governed Persia for nearly 300 years.
Buildings in a balcony are held up by columns. The compass window turns to show a title.
Thus taught Zoroaster.
A man walks through a large field.
Many, many years ago, while the Persians were still living in high mountain valleys, an old shepherd saw a solitary man descending a hill one morning.
The shepherd watches.
I think I recognize that person. A few years ago, a young man passed by here. His name was Zoroaster. But if this is the same man, he looks a lot different.
He turns.
I have been living in a cave for 10 years. The solitude has helped me to reflect, and now I am full of wisdom, and I need to tell people of all the things I have learned.
And so it was that Zoroaster became a great prophet. He taught people to think and see the world in a new way. For him, there were not many gods, but only one. A unique, magnificent, and creative force. And that force is called Ahura Mazda.
It has long wings.
Zoroaster taught that the sun reigns with its light during the day, blessing the world with its energy. But as sunset arrives, it hides away, thus allowing darkness to control the night.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.